Hello, in this video I will show you how to get more out of your Arduino by means of deep programming. In this episode I talk about the I/O pins. The library has the functions digital read and digital write, so control the digital I/Os. These are very easy to use, you only have to parameterize them with the pin number and logic level, that's it. But let us check how fast this works. Let us try the famous blink example without the delays and measure the output signal. First, I connect the probe to pin D13 and ground. Okay, there we see the output of pin D13. Frequency is about 145 kHz. That might be enough for most use cases. Let us now set the pin directly via its port register. First, I replace the pin mode command with this line and the digital write by that. I will explain later what I did. And now the frequency is 2 MHz, that's about 14 times faster. And it was in fact very easy to code this. Look into the disassembly of the digital write function. As you can see, the digital write performs many checks before it finally sets the output pin. And that's the reason why it performs so slow. But the disassembly of the optimized catch shows that it is executed directly, without any time-consuming checks. Furthermore, when we compare the memory usage after compiling, the code which calls the digital write function needs 734 bytes of program memory, while the optimized code needs 450 bytes. That's a considerable saving of memory. Now I will explain the idea that's behind this. The digital pins are grouped into I/O ports. For example, the Atmega 328 has three I/O ports, which are port B, C and D. Each of these has 7 or 8 I/O pins. On this picture, you can also see how the port pins are mapped to the I/O pins of the Arduino itself. For example, pin 5 of port B is joined to pin D13 of the Arduino. The ports are controlled by 8-bit registers. The data direction register sets the port pins either as input or as output. For example, setting bit 5 of the data direction register of port B will configure pin B5 alias D13 as output. The data direction registers are abbreviated with DDR, followed by the port name. Okay, now it comes to writing the sketch. First, in the setup function, I want to configure pin B5 as output. So I set bit 5 in the data direction register of port B. With the port registers, I can define the output levels of the pins which I have previously defined as output. So in the loop function, I switch pin 13 on by setting the bit 5 in the port B register and off after that by clearing that bit. That's all. By the way, if you like this tutorial, feel free to give it a thumb up, subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications so you won't miss anything. Another advantage of directly programming the port control registers is that I can easily set several port pins simultaneously. Instead of calling the digital write function several times, it is much more efficient to write the bits directly to the port register. As an example, I show you how to code a 7-segment driver. Instead of 7-segment displays made with LEDs, I use a VF display tube here. VF displays were very popular from the 1970s until the 2000s, and they are a nice alternative to LED displays on IXI tubes. Check out my video about how to interface VFDs with an Arduino if you want to know more. In order to display numbers on a 7-segment display, we need 7 I/O pins, one for each segment. In this example, I joined bit 0 until 2 of port B and bit 4 until 7 of port D to the segments. Port B by 3 is connected to the decimal point. In the sketch, there is an array which contains a combination of the different output bits. For example, on position 7, the bit that controls segment E, F and G are set. In the setup function, I configure the data direction registers. And in the loop function, I read the values that I want to display from the array, mask the upper and lower 4 bits and assign them to their respective port registers. After a delay of 1 second, I increase the counter by 1 and display the next number. A little tip here, setting a bit in the pin register toggles the corresponding output bit. So we let the decimal point blink. The bit resets itself immediately, so we do not need to reset it by ourselves. Next, I show you how to peak the digital inputs. I added a push button and a pull-up resistor to pin D12. Now I am going to modify the sketch in a way that the counter counts up whenever I press the button. I could of course use the digital read function there, but I can also peak the I/O bit in the pin register of the I/O port. This is also very easy. Take a glimpse on the pin out and notice that pin 12 is joined to port B, byte 4, so I increase the counter and display its value whenever the button is pressed and the pin goes low. The Atmega ports have internal pull-up resistors, which I can activate by setting the respective bits in the port register. With this, when bit 4 in port B is set, the external pull-up resistor can be omitted. Now keep in mind that 3 registers control the port. The data direction register, the port register and the pin register. Depending on the port configuration, port and pin have different functions. When a port is configured as input, the pin registers contain the logic levels of the input lines. The bits in the port register control the pull-up resistors. When a port is configured as output, the port register bits set the output levels of the IOs and the bits in the pin register toggle the output bits. That's it. Feel free to post your comments down below, share my videos and subscribe to my channel if you like. See you soon. Take care. Bye.